Welcome to this new video tutorial. In this video, I will show you the easiest way how you could download and set up Windows 10 in your SP flash drive or an SD card so that you can use it later for creating a bootable device, or you can use it for an installation or formatting Windows. So to do that, you need to connect to internet, open your browser and type download Windows 10. Hit enter. You need to check the official website www.microsoft.com, and below it there is download Windows 10 disk image. We're not really going to download the disk image, we're going actually to do something different. So click on it to start. Scroll down until you see create Windows 10 installation media. To get started, you will first need to have a license to install Windows 10. You can then download. This is the general terms. However, we will go to download now. Make sure that you have a USB flash drive with at least 8 GB capacity, or an SD card with at least 8 GB capacity. Once you click on this little downloaded tool, Windows will ask you if you really want to allow this application to make changes. Just click yes. You will see the Windows logo appearing. You can go ahead and close all of this. And Windows will tell you that it's getting a few things ready. We will wait until it's done and we will continue. So getting things ready is over. Now it's the applicable notice and license terms. I invite you to read through. If you decline, you will not be able to download and set up Windows 10. But if you accept, you will be able. So read the notice and decide what you want to do. For now, I will click accept. And again, getting few things ready. It will take just a few seconds to 1 minute maximum to be done. And then we'll be prompted to make our choices. So as a next step, you don't want to upgrade this PC. You want to create installation media, USB flash drive, DVD or ISO file for another PC, and you click next. Windows will try to detect the settings of your computer and it will offer you, for example, my computer's language is Czech, so it's offering me Czech language. My computer's edition is matching with Windows, so it's giving me Windows 10 as I want. And my computer's architecture is 64-bit. There are two types of computers. There are those which are running under 32-bit architecture and those with 64-bit. So if you are setting up Windows 10 and you are running Windows 7 on your computer or Windows 8, Windows will automatically detect and will give you the best option if you want to use it for that computer. If you are not sure, you can always read the box for other architecture, the carton box of your computer, or you can always check if the computer is another device. Just go to that device if it's running Windows and type dxdiag, regardless of the version of your computer. I mean, if you are running Windows XP 7, 8, 8.1, it doesn't matter, that because this command works on all of them and you will be able to see the settings of the computer. So for example, here, operating system, 64-bit. And that's exactly what it's offering me. If you are unsure or you don't know, just untick use the recommended settings. And here you can choose both. And it will set up both for you in the USB and you will be able to use it for installation. So for me, for now, I need just 64-bit and I need English language. So I will check or change to English United Kingdom. So I changed the language. The version cannot be changed, Windows 10. Architecture, I selected 64. You can either select 32 or 64 or even both, so that you can use that flash drive to install on any computer. It will be compatible with all computers. And I will click next. Here it's asking me if I want to create a USB flash drive. Here you can use a USB flash drive, or you can use an SD card or an external hard disk. And Windows will be set up on that one so that you can use it for installation. If you would like just the ISO file, then you can just select the ISO file. So for now, we'll keep with USB flash drive and I will click next. I need to check which USB flash drive or which SD card. I remember that it's under the I letter, but I can always go to my PC shortcut. And this is my USB flash drive or my SD card, which I want to use. And it's called iOS under the I letter. So here I will select iOS, I letter, and I will click next. Windows will start getting things ready. Please make sure that your USB flash drive or your SD card or your external hard disk which you are using is completely empty. No data is supposed to be there, because Windows, once it's almost ready to be run, it will do a format before saving the Windows software in that USB flash drive or that SD card. So make sure that you have no data there, otherwise it will be lost. I will just pause the video here because this step is supposed to take between 5 to 15 minutes based on how fast is your internet and how fast is your USB flash drive or SD card read and write speed. And I will take back once there is a manual steps to follow, because from now on everything should be automatic except 2 or 3 clicks which we need to do. I will take back this video in a bit. So now our process is over and the USB flash drive or the SD card is ready to be used for the installation or for the format. Windows is already there and ready to be used. As I click, I see all the files, the boot file, EFI, sources, supports, etc. and the setup. We will just click finish. Setup will be cleaning it up before it closes. We can go ahead and recheck again from our PC shortcut. And here we have it. To further check if it's working or not, just double click on the setup. Windows will ask you if you want to allow the app to make changes. Just click yes to see. And normally we should see the Windows logo prompting and we should see the window telling us things. Windows. Preparing, and let's see. If this first step goes smoothly, it means that everything has been perfectly done and there should be no problems. Here we go. I hope this video tutorial was helpful to you guys. If you are still in need of help or assistance, just write us a comment or send us an email and we'll do our best to help you. If you'd like to encourage us, you can always join our channel for monthly subscription and you can always like and share and subscribe to get our latest videos. Thank you for watching and talk to you soon in a new video tutorial.